Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I'm talking kind of low because everybody's already in the bed. I'm getting ready to go to bed here. And I was just thinking, I'm going to put the links below here. I know I made at least one video when I was in the Philippines, probably in about April or the beginning of May of this year, of where I mentioned in a couple of different in the videos or so that the Lord was leading me to study all about the assassination of JFK. And the thing that the Lord was telling me is that, you know, it's a pattern of the New World Order and how they will bring in the New World Order. I mentioned this in a video, I think, the other day when the first Ebola case was out in Dallas. So it's just kind of weird. It's kind of stuff that I wouldn't, you know, normally make a video about, but it's just so weird. Okay, so first of all, of course, John F. Kennedy was killed in Dallas. And so I'd been studying about that and didn't know why, other than the Lord was telling me that it was a pattern of how the New World Order would come into power and how the New World Order operates. And so Kennedy was killed in Dallas, and then the first Ebola patient, which could lead, you know, to them bringing in martial law and all this if it becomes a pandemic, you know, started in Dallas. So that was kind of a little bit strange, and I thought, well, you know, when it happened, I was like, you know, felt in my heart from the Lord, yeah, this is important. So I mentioned that in a video the other day. And then the other day I saw that the nurse, the Asian American nurse who was evacuated from Dallas to the National Institute of Health in Maryland, the NIH, they flew her out of Love Field. Now those of you who know the history, you will know that President Kennedy landed in Love Field, not at, you know, I don't know if they had Dallas Fort Worth, I guess they didn't, but President Kennedy landed at Love Field before he took his famous motorcade into Dallas and killed there in Dealey Plaza. So I thought, you know, when I heard about that, I was like quickened again that, hey, that's the same place that John F. Kennedy landed. And I thought, well, it's just a coincidence. And then just now, a few minutes ago, I was checking my messages from my last video that I loaded this afternoon and looking at checking my emails and stuff. And, you know, I just realized that the new Ebola patient came through JFK Airport in New York. And so that's just like the trifecta of strangeness and bizarreness. It really is a pattern, you know, and I usually don't, you know, get on those things, but it was just so strange. And I thought, you know, because the Lord had really quickened it in my spirit. So, you know, unfortunately, you know, and I hope it's not going to happen, but it seems that Ebola, or even though in my mind I actually feel like it may even be something else that will come in, not Ebola not being the very thing, but something else would come behind it that would bring in the martial law and the, you know, ultimately lead to martial law in the United States and lead to the rise of the New World Order and the tribulation period. So, you know, I don't know, but the Ebola definitely has the potential of bringing in, you know, causing serious unrest, because I just saw, you know, they're talking about mandatory quarantines and, you know, New York, of course, New York is a very Nazi place and very radical fascist government that, you know, of course, they don't have Bloomberg anymore. And then New Jersey, that area, you know, they're very, the government is very draconian up there. They don't really care about civil liberties. You know, they have no gun rights and all this, even though it's in the Constitution we do, but not in those states. And the people seem to go along with that and seem to think it's great. So, anyway, brothers and sisters, I just wanted to make that quick video and mention those things. There's probably some more that I'm not thinking of. But anyway, you know, we as a church, you know, we should be praying that all the people that's going to get saved and go in the rapture will get saved now and go in the rapture. You know, we should pray, because we know, though, that the Lord is tarrying, and because he wishes none to perish, but all to come to repentance. And we know there's a fullness, as I mentioned in the video I loaded earlier tonight. There's a fullness of times. There's a fullness of the Gentiles. There's a certain number of people that will get saved, truly saved. And when that happens, it'll be the end of the age of the Gentiles. It'll be time for the rapture and the start of the tribulation. So we should pray, you know, for anybody out there who should be getting saved, that they would hurry up and do it. We should pray, you know, for you know, the Lord to, even though we want the rapture to happen, and most of my viewers, you know, you guys are very excited about the rapture, but remember, when we're gone, you know, you're going to have relatives who are left behind. There are going to be people left behind. And of course, you know, obviously they, you know, maybe they'll get saved in a tribulation and be tribulation saints, or maybe they'll never be saved. Of course, they've got their free will. That's ultimately their decision and their problem between them and God. But remember that once the rapture happens, you won't have a chance to talk to them again. You won't have a chance to pray for them again. So you should, you know, make every effort today as if it were the last day. Because even if the rapture doesn't happen tomorrow, and then there's martial law, you know, I'm pretty sure that, you know, it's going to be chaos. Telephone service, you know, just like they've done. See, they've already been practicing this. And Obama asked for a kill switch, and his advisors, they set it up with Homeland Security. There's a kill switch for the internet. There's a kill switch for cell phone service and all that. Of course, they've got it all planned. They've already practiced it in other countries. If you've been keeping up with the news, they've used the kill switch in other countries when things were going on. I'm trying to remember right now. I know in Iran they have. In some other countries they've used a kill switch to block, you know, they claim. Or in Egypt, too. You know, trying to block people from social media so they could, you know, have a rally for a protest and all that stuff. They're definitely been practicing all that stuff to use right here in the most dangerous country on earth to the New World Order. You know, the representative republic, middle class, educated Christian America. That's who they want to stop. You know, once they defeat us, of course, most of the rest of the countries are a bunch of wimps. The Europeans are already wimpy and rolled over. And all your third world countries, of course, they've already got them in the pocket, like Mexico. You know, in Mexico, it's illegal to have guns, like the Marine that's locked up down there in Mexico. Of course, it's so hilarious or sad, ironic, you know, that how many tens of thousands of Mexicans have been killed by guns in their drug wars, but yet an individual Mexican citizen cannot own guns unless they're rich and they have special permits and all this. So, those countries have already surrendered their sovereign, you know, God-given rights. As our Declaration of Independence says, you know, we are endowed by our Creator from God with certain inalienable rights. So we're the only country with that constitution. Even Canada and Australia and those other countries, they're still under, technically they're under the Queen of England. You know, we're really the only, you know, constitutional sovereign nation on earth. That has the rights that we have, and it's really, you know, a fruit of the Judeo-Christian history of our country, and that's why we're so dangerous to the New World Order. But what they don't know is God, you know, they don't believe or they don't know God has a trick up his sleeve, and that's the rapture of the church. You know, we're going to be out of here, and that's the actual trump card for the church, for the bride of Christ. But for the rest of Americans who are not truly born-again Christians, it's going to be hell on earth. For the rest of the world, it's going to be left behind. So remember those people, you know, and that you would not have any regrets when you get to heaven about someone that you should have talked to about the Lord and didn't do it. Someone you should have prayed for and you didn't do it. So make sure that you can do all you can do today while it's still called a day before it's everlasting, eternally too late. God bless you guys. See you soon.